once you enter into any place in Europe, you get access to all other places in Europe. So I got a lot of rejections initially. And that's when I shifted to, I thought, the thing is, I'm not from a CS background, so, and I wanted to do data science and ML kind of courses.
Okay, so why specifically, there are like...
Even if you don't have a scholarship, it's cheaper as compared to US universities. Fees reductions and partly free and stuff. In Netherlands, that's a huge plus because more than 80-85% of the people speak English. But the thing was, this course was really, really interesting. I mean... And I faced a huge issue initially while I was applying to colleges because they don't say it's hard and fast. So we think, okay, it's fine. It's just a preference. I'll just apply. Currently, there's like this huge hype for AI and ML, right? Whatever you do, people say, okay, you use AI and ML and there's a lot of courses coming up. Okay, so what do you use AI and ML for, right? So there's a shift, roughly 2 years of work experience, primarily in data analytics.
Hi everyone. Today we have Gowtham with us from TU Eindhoven. So Gowtham, can you give a brief introduction about yourself?
Yes. Hey Sharath, thank you for having me. My name is Gowtham Balachandran and I am from Kerala, specifically Trivandrum. And I did my undergraduate studies in electrical engineering, basically electronics. So I did it from a college in Trivandrum itself called College of Engineering Trivandrum. And I completed on 2019. Then after graduation, I did about roughly 2 years of work experience, primarily in data analytics. So I first worked in a company called Mu Sigma for a while. And then from Mu Sigma, I went to ZS Associates. So both of them were kind of similar roles, which was around, like analytics and data analytics and high level machine learning and stuff. And then from there, I wanted to do more or study more about this whole machine learning and AI, and then decided to go for masters. And yeah, and then I came to masters in Netherlands in TUE. Yeah.
Okay. So why specifically, there are like other countries, people usually go for US or Canada, or even in Europe, they usually go for Germany, France. Why you specifically chosen Netherlands for your masters?
Okay. So I guess when I was first deciding on which country to go to, I had Europe in mind. So Europe was always a place where I wanted to go to study. And I guess the reason for that would be, there's a lot of reasons. Financial, a big reason was there because as compared to US universities, European universities are much less expensive. Even if you don't have a scholarship, it's cheaper as compared to US universities. And so Europe was a main big choice for me. And also apart from that, there was like a good community of researchers and people who work on the whole machine learning AI space within Europe. Good colleges offering, similar courses. So Europe was like a good, and another thing I think is important is once you enter into any place in Europe, you get access to all other places in Europe. So that's something really good. So you can travel, get a lot of exposure to different countries. So for all those reasons, I chose Europe and specifically Netherlands, I guess. So I had a friend who studies in TU Eindhoven. He's studying mechanical. So he was my batchmate in college. So he's the one who actually introduced me to TU Eindhoven, and I was interested in the beginning, but then when I started studying more about the whole atmosphere in Netherlands, their study, the way they teach the masters, and also the work opportunities here, I got so much more interested. And in TUE, they specifically offered a course, which the one I'm doing, which is AIES, Artificial Intelligence Engineering Systems, which is a specialization within electrical. So that was like a very perfect fit for me. And I decided Netherlands. And also to your other question, which was why not Germany? Yes, Germany was also one of the, countries that I wanted to go to within Europe. But one major barrier for me was language. Although yes, there was a lot of fees reductions and partly free and stuff. I always felt that the payback on that in terms of the language barrier was huge. Like, whatever technical knowledge you have, you need to be also good in German in order to land a job finally. Some people, for them, is okay, but I thought, that was a big no for me. So in Netherlands, that's a huge plus because more than 80-85% of the people speak English, and their official language in workplaces is also English. So I was like, yeah, all those reasons attracted me towards Netherlands, and I got an opportunity here, so I just came for it.
Then why specifically TU Eindhoven? TU Delft and other universities as well. So why did you choose TU Eindhoven particularly?
Okay, so that's also a good question. So Eindhoven specifically is because of this course, I would say. So Eindhoven, as you know, it's a TUE, it's a really good college, it's really prestigious, it's there. And as I mentioned before, my friend Akshay, he's a student, he's the one who introduced me to the college. And TU Delft was also a close competitor. You often people say, when they say Netherlands, the first name that comes is Delft. So Delft was also there. But the thing was, this course was really, really interesting. I mean, if I talk a bit about my background, I studied, as you know, electronics and instrumentation, basically. So from there, due to my final year project and kind of the work experience I got hooked into the whole AIML kind of a space. And I faced a huge issue initially while I was applying to colleges, because the thing is, I'm not from a CS background, so, and I wanted to do data science and ML kind of courses. So a big mistake I did was I applied to a lot of core data science courses in Europe and Canada also, to some universities. And the problem is that although they do not specify it in the prerequisites, they say it's preferred if you have certain courses in CS, like data structures, data, you know, algorithms, databases, but they don't say it's hard and fast. So we think, okay, it's fine, it's just a preference, I'll just apply. But the fact is, it's they consider that very, very important. Like changing your degree from an undergraduate electrical to computer science oriented AI, which is basically AIML, is very difficult. I got a lot of rejections initially, and that's when I shifted to, I thought, okay, that's not the good thing to do. I should go for an undergraduate degree, which is electrical, and then look for AI ML specializations within electrical. And that's when this course, I came upon this course, which is called Artificial Intelligence Engineering Systems. And it's a specialization track within electrical. So what they do is they just take all the electives within electrical, which specializes on, you know, ML and AI domain. So like computer vision, signal processing, or a lot of stuff are there which within electrical that uses AI and ML, right? So so they encompass that into a new course, AIES. So I was actually really, I love that course because it matched my profile really well. I could build a story for why I wanted to go for that course in my SOP based on my background. So that worked out. So that was the main reason I chose TU Eindhoven. That's the main reason.
So the AIES is part of a new department that has initialized in TU Eindhoven, right? So it's a newly started course, and you have a lot more, space to talk with the professors and do things, right?
Exactly, yeah, that's so true. It's a newly, so the thing is, yeah, it's kind of like a new specialization that they brought out. But essentially what it is, it's just, as I mentioned, it's just compiling a lot of courses or electives that use AI and ML in electrical domain. And not just electrical, they offer it in tie up with a lot of other departments too, like electrical, mechanical, chemical, and a lot of stuff. So currently there's like this huge hype for AI and ML, right? Whatever you do, people say, okay, you use AI and ML, and there's a lot of courses coming up. But the fact is that currently there's another shift that is going on, is people are starting to realize that AI and ML is just a tool people use, right? So there's something that you need to solve, and you use artificial intelligence or ML methods to solve that. So if I do just a course in AI and ML, which is also good, there'll be a question, okay, so what do you use AI and ML for, right? So there's a shift coming up regarding that. And people are currently looking at their own domain, which is whatever it may be, electrical or mechanical, even non-engineering, like finance, biology, physics, and they're seeing, there is a problem in this domain, and I can use AI and ML to solve that problem. So that's essentially what artificial intelligence engineering systems course entails. So that's their motive for the course. You're in different departments, use AI and ML to solve problems in that department. So,
and also with respect to rejection from like other countries and industry, you said, I think apart from, you know, the preferred requirements, there are other candidates from that particular department, for example, CSE, who is competing with you.
Exactly.
So it makes a lot more sense to give an admission to them rather than, you know, from electrical engineering or some other department. And I think that's the main reason, one of the main reason we get rejected, because I got rejected a lot in few courses when I was applying for Germany.
Okay. Exactly. That's, yeah, that's so true.
So what are the typical requirements for studying in TU Eindhoven or any university in, within our lands?
Okay. So the typical requirements are usually GRE is not that mandatory here, especially in Europe. It's good to have it, but especially in TUE and Netherlands, they do not look at it like a cutoff thing. So if you have that, it's good. And then obviously you need your language requirement tests, specifically IELTS or TOEFL. And they have like minimum cutoffs in IELTS, which is, I guess, around 6.5. But that differs between departments too. So it's better to look at the specific university. But still, like a good 7 in IELTS would be really important. And then GPA is also pretty important here. So in some departments, they do have like a cutoff of 8, 8.5. But generally, it's always good to have like a GPA above 7.5. Especially in TU, and I guess TU Delft also has this kind of requirement. So it's good to have like a good GPA. And another thing is work experience. So if you have work experience, I think it really helps in especially building up your SOP and also convincing the academic committee, admissions committee to take you in because you have a purpose. So I guess, yeah, that four things sums it up. Like GRE, if you have it, that's good. IELTS, definitely. And then GPA, good GPA. And work experience, if you have it, that's also good.
So how did you apply to like a university in Netherlands? So let's say I'm a student who graduated.
Okay.
I want to apply. That should be the point I should be looking at. And is there any particular portal? It's a general application procedure or specific to one particular, each university has their own portal or something like this?
Yeah. So in Netherlands, each university has its own portal. So if you want to apply to TU Eindhoven, you just directly go to their portal. Enter their website, go to the specific department. And another thing I would stress is before you go into the application process, it's always good to make sure you meet the eligibility criteria. So look at the department, read through the department's criteria. If you have any doubt, it's always best to email them too. So just make sure you don't get rejected just because you don't match the criteria, right? So make sure about that. And then everything else is pretty straightforward. So you just follow the procedures in the website. You have to keep all your documents ready. So by documents, I mean you need your statement of purpose, you need good reference letters, 3 reference letters ideally, 2 academic and 1 professional. And you have all your other test results like IELTS test scores, and then you need your transcripts from your college, undergraduate transcripts, grade sheets, all those sort of things. And once that's done, you have, yeah, that's all. And then if you have any proof of work experience and stuff like that, you can add up all those, keep it ready. And then just follow the procedure on the website. It's very straightforward. It's a bit time consuming. You need to, you know, go through all the questions, upload documents, make sure that you've done that. And it's just a bit tedious, but it's very straightforward. So you can do that completely throughout the portal of the college university. Yeah.
So there is no application fee. Do I have to send any documents from India via post?
Mm-hmm. So initially, there is an application fee, which is pretty standard to most European universities. It's the same amount it comes to. And regarding the hard copy, currently, because of the whole pandemic thing, at least in the initial phase, you don't need to send anything. At least in Netherlands. I think in Germany and stuff, you need to like send like an attested copy or something. But in Netherlands, you do not need to do that. Once, if you get admitted, if you pass the first round or phase, then they ask you to send the documents to verify whether everything is correct. So only then you need to look about it. But before application, it's fine. You need all the originals with you, but a scanned copy would be perfect.